Hi, my name is Daniel Myers, and this is another episode of Powered by Snowflake, where I interview technology leaders who are building businesses and applications on top of Snowflake. Today, I'm interviewing Frederick Robinette, the CTO and co-founder of ViaNova, a data platform built on Snowflake that uses connected vehicle data to help cities and mobility operators build more efficient and sustainable transport systems for people and goods. Frederick, how are you?
Good, and you, Daniel?
Awesome. So, you know, I want to learn more about you as a person, and like, kind of, how did you get started in this space, and why did you start this company as a co-founder?
Yeah, that's a really good question. Thanks for having me in this interview, Daniel. So why I joined ViaNova and I co-founded this company, because I kind of touched the mobility space while I was in Renault Nissan Mitsubishi as a lead platform and connected architecture for vehicle. And I had the chance, you know, to enter some robo taxi vehicle around Yokohama, because for OEMs, it's really important to have electrical vehicle, connected vehicle, autonomous vehicle. So those are the three pillars. And this is where I entered this mobility space. And I was thinking, wow, it's huge, it's big. It will change our life soon, but maybe we cannot notice that. But tomorrow we will have a lot of new vehicle generation running 24/7 in the cities, helping us to move from A to B with a seamless experience. So yeah, that's when I was completely convinced by the mobility space. And recently in Europe, we saw an increasing number of micro mobility providers, you know, coming to the street, proposing their services with moped, bicycle, all the free-floating vehicles that you can usually find in big European cities. So it was welcomed very well by citizens, but at the same time, it was kind of challenging for cities because they see an increasing number of devices on the public right-of-way, and people also started to complain because there was some chaos in the street. So we saw that as an opportunity in terms of helping the city to better understand how the micro-mobility behaves, what are the trends, the patterns from, you know, mobility hubs, usage of the mobility mix, and also give the provider a possibility to show the city that they are compliant to their regulation.
Awesome, awesome. So can you show us a demo today of the platform that you've built, and kind of explain, you know, how you're solving that problem today?
Yeah, sure. So let me share my screen. So this is our dashboarding. We are putting a lot of effort in the user experience because we think this is super important for the client to have something that is accessible and easy to use, but also at the same time that is showing the values and the KPI that they are looking for in a really fast and efficient manner. So in this example, it's a demo environment for Zurich, but you can see that we are providing a really good map visualization, so you can see the heat map of the devices, where are the devices in the Zurich city. You can also click on them, know the device status, what is the latest information, have also general trends, the number of devices across times, the fleet availability, which is also important for the city to be sure that the service is well executed, that citizens can access all the devices. We can also show the number of trips that have been taken. It's always aggregated per hour in order to be compliant with the GDPR constraint. It's important for us also to not disclose too many details when it comes to people privacy. So this is something that we are really cautious about. And we are giving this exaggerated visualization of all the district and sub-districts. So generally speaking, in the GIS world, it's origin and destination. So what are the most popular origin when it comes to this particular district or sub-district and things like that. You can also have this per street segment number of trips over a time period, which is super useful for the city to understand what are the most used corridors across the city. For example, in order to prioritize their investment into future or possible cycling lanes, it is super important for them to take the right decision, especially after COVID. We saw a huge number of temporary cycle lanes in order to let people cycle and bicycle around the city. So this is something super useful for them. We give the exact same thing in terms of parking segment. So you can see where are the most parked devices. And this is also something that the city are looking for in order to avoid crowded streets with a lot of micro-mobility devices. We are giving also the number across a large amount of period, so it can be from one day to actually the whole history. And this is where we think also Snowflake is really helping us, because at the end it's a lot of that of data. If you think about one device could be able to give you like 300 telemetries per trip, and usually a device is taking from 1 to 3 trips per day. So at the end of the day and at the end of the month, it's a huge number of data, and we were kind of struggling with our infrastructure using Postgres. Then we need to invest a lot of time into, okay, how many Postgres server do we need? What could be the size of the cluster? How can we route the queries? And we truly believe that our value is in the service that we are creating rather than, you know, maintaining an infrastructure or a cluster of database. So this is really where Snowflake is helping us, because it's so easy for us to decide and provision the cluster and the size of the cluster. It's like instantly applied. So thanks to Snowflake, we are able to really invest time in our product. Another view that is super useful for cities are the control page. So here they can see a clear photo or picture of the actual fleet across the whole city. They can see potential bottleneck, where are the unavailable vehicles, so they can take action directly contacting the provider. Hey, we think there is an issue here. There are too much unavailable devices, and also real-time infraction. So they have the capacity to digitally create the regulation that are physically applied, but then we use the power of Snowflake to cross geofence with telemetries, and this is super useful for us that by joining the beta program, now we are able to use this kind of fast computing algorithm, knowing the number of regulation telemetry that a city can have. It's super powerful, so we can give them in real time the number of digital infraction to be confirmed, but they have this view of what could be the potential problems or bottleneck and take action directly. So as I said, another module for them is being able to draw some regulation so they can decide, okay, in my city, there is an area where I don't want any device to be there, so I can go in my city, start drafting a regulation, which is also super useful for them, so they can say, okay, in this area, this is a no-go zone. Nobody should be able to start a trip or end a trip for any temporary reason, some market or, you know, a temporary event happening in the street. So then the regulation will be communicated to the operator that will directly show that in the front-end application or the mobile app in order to help really the city better organize the public right-of-way.
That's awesome. So it's incredibly powerful to see the amount of visualization and the amount of information that you can glean from this micro-mobility data. And so what, you know, you mentioned a few of the actions that these operators are taking. Like, for example, they can help prioritize investment in certain areas. That's really cool to see. What other, you know, examples of outcomes can people have from this type of data and your platform?
Yeah, sure. That's a really good question. So we have several use cases. For example, we help Brussels Capital to organize and create what we call the mobility hubs. So those are dedicated places where usually provider will drop off the vehicle in order to fulfill the demand, because we saw some increasing pattern of in front of this train station, for example, there was a lot of trip starting, so there is a demand here, and it would be great if operators can prepare their device and let them available in this particular space. And also it helps also to better organize where people can actually find those devices. It's not everywhere in the street. It's really in one place. They know the place. It's marked everywhere. So this is the kind of use case. And after using our product, Bosel was able to create between 10 or 15 mobility hubs spray painted across the city. And we also then give them the usage of those mobility hubs, how many devices are starting from there to go in which region of the city. So better analytics and usage around those mobility hubs.
Awesome. Awesome. And you touched on also kind of the transition point of when you moved to Snowflake and kind of your thoughts around that. Can you expand and kind of explain a little bit more on what your specific evaluation criteria was and how did you land specifically on Snowflake?
Yeah, sure. That's a really good question. So in order to make the best choice, we had several options in mind, and several also competitors. But what make us take this decision was first, I think, the human contact and also the availability of people on Snowflake side. We had a dedicated engineer to answer our question, all the things that we had in mind. Also, Thomas from Snowflake was a really good partner to help us make the contract and follow at each step of our reflection and thinking by providing answer in the right manner. So I think it was the first criteria for us to have this human contact and people that we can talk to directly. Secondly, it was for sure the cost, how much it will cost for us to migrate everything to Snowflake. Considering the total cost of ownership, because usually we think about the running cost, but also the maintenance and things like that. So that's why also we decided to go for Snowflake. And the third thing was the actual efficiency of Snowflake in terms of storage, data warehousing, and also capacity for us, for example, as you see, to retrieve 12 months of historical data in a fastly manner, which could have taken maybe several minutes in the previous architecture with PostgreSQL. Now with Snowflake, we can do it within 10 or 5 seconds, and it's super snappy. So those are the three main thing that decide us to go for Snowflake.
As you're building out this company, right, and this product, what are some of the challenges that you've encountered throughout the journey? And from this journey, like what's next on the horizon?
Yeah, so the first, engineering milestone was the scalability, because if our business goes well, then the engineering side needs to follow. So increasing the number of cities, now we are having more than 20 European cities on our platform. So it needs to grow in parallel with the business. Also having more and more provider, more and more data point for each day. So this is really the first engineering milestone. And now we feel much more confident after migrating to Snowflake that it can scale almost infinitely. Then it's just a question of cost and pricing, but at least on the technical side, we feel really confident. So the second biggest engineering milestone was the GIS world. So as we are a GIS platform, meaning geographical information and data analytics, it's really important for us to be able to manipulate polygons, shapes, GPS location, and now we have entered the beta program of the GIS Snowflake feature, and we are super happy. We managed to reduce calls that were taken 1 minute to 5 seconds with the new GIS capabilities of Snowflake. So this is super cool. cool for us because it was one of the gray area, knowing that Postgres is really powerful when it comes to geospatial information. But now we think that Snowflake is almost at the same level, at least for our use case. And the next big milestone for us will be machine learning and artificial intelligence. How can we better optimize fleet? Our goal, for example, or the city goal, are to reduce the CO2 emissions. So we are now working on using our data and machine learning algorithms to propose some policies in order to reduce that by proposing, instead of taking your personal car and thermic car, you can choose to have a micro-mobility device for your 1 to 5 kilometer trip, which will reduce the CO2 fingerprint overall. So this is super cool, and we are excited to be working on those use cases soon.
That's awesome. That's awesome. And so if one of our viewers today wants to learn more about you or more about your company, where should they go?
You can go on vianova.io. Everything is there. You can contact us. We explain what we do. You have also a partner program, so you can find all the useful information. We can plan a demo with you. And also, we have a lot of white paper, and also we are writing a lot of content around micromobility and what we really believe for the cities and the smart city in the future. So go on vianova.io. You will find everything you need.
Awesome. And so for everybody here today, my name is Daniel Myers. This has been another episode of Powered by Snowflake. If you want to learn how you can build your business and your application on Snowflake, check out developers.snowflake.com. Thanks. See you next time.